What if you don't have a flat surface to draw your sketch? In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create planes so that you have a flat surface to create your sketches on. Just to reinforce what we've learned in the past, remember, go into Options, Unit, Document Properties, Units, and make sure you have inches or millimeters if you choose to draw in millimeters. Select it. Now, if you remember, we have three planes that we've been drawing on: the front plane, the top plane, and the right plane. But what if we need another spot to draw on? We can go into Surfaces and select Reference Geometry. Now, this menu may be in another spot in SolidWorks, depending on what version you have and how it's set up. But look around and you'll find Reference Geometry. And you're gonna select Plane. Now what we have is some choices. We go here into the menu that now shows up in the main window, and we pick the front plane. And now we have a couple of choices. Let's say we want to offset by 6 inches. As you can see, we now have two planes that we're able to draw on. We have our front plane, and also now we have another plane offset by 6 inches. Now, why would we want to do that? Let's take a look. If we right click on this plane, we can select Sketch. And I've been doing a lot of boxes, so this time we'll pick a circle. And we'll make that circle 2.5 inches. We're going to exit the sketch, because I'm going to show you an interesting and neat trick within SolidWorks. Now we want to find that other plane that's parallel. It's over here, the front plane. We're also going to create a sketch on that one. So let's do that. And a little trick, what you can do is you can right click and then you can select Normal 2, and it actually makes your plane flat to your view. And we can select another circle. Now we're looking through, so seeing that other plane that we drew on. And let's make this one 1.5 inches. And let's look at that in 3D. So we have two-dimensional drawings on two separate planes within a 3D space. There's still no real dimensions to these. They're still flat with just two dimensions. There's no thickness to either one of them, but they're offset, remember, by 6 inches. So that allows us to do some interesting things. If we look up at the top, we can go to Features, and we have Lofted Base. Now watch what happens when we select this. It's going to ask us for the two profiles. So we're going to select this profile and this profile. And look what happens. We've now created a cone. It's a solid object, just like we've been doing before. Now there's a couple of things we can do with this cone, just so you can learn some more features. One of the neat things we could do is we could go to Features, and up here we can look for Shell. And we can simply select this surface, and we'll do a thickness of 0.25. And as you can see, it created a wall thickness of 0.25. Now, interestingly enough, it didn't go all the way through because it also made this back end 0.25. So technically, we've just made sort of a cup. And if we wanted to look a little further, we can do what we learned in our last episode, which is we can select the section view. It's facing the wrong direction, but we can simply change it and hit OK. And now we can see that the wall thickness is even throughout. And we made this complex shape simply by making two sketches that were offset by 6 inches. Let's do a little more so I can show you more about sketches. Suppose, and I don't know why you would do this, but let's just suppose for a second you would want a pipe sticking out of the side of this design. We could go to the top plane, which is in the center, as you can see. But suppose we wanted to draw directly on the surface. For whatever reason, we don't want this pipe to go through to the center. Well, we can create another plane using our reference geometry. We can go plane. The easiest way to do this would be to select our middle plane and then change our offset. Was it 3 inches? No, it was 2.5. So we'll make this 1.25, and that should, yes it does, puts us with this plane right on the surface. Now, we have a couple of interesting problems that we're going to run into, but we'll try to fix them. So, let's just assume we want the pipe to end here. We right-click on this plane. We can create a center line. And remember, center lines are for reference. They don't actually become part of the object. They simply are used for our dimensions. We can create our pipe that we're going to do. We can do a smart dimension here. We'll make it 2 inches. And we'll make this 1 inch. We still have a dimension that's not showing, if you remember. And again, this is why this is really good. We get to, and you can see that that point did not lock to the edge. So we can go back to sketch and look for our add relation. We're going to add a relation, going to add this point, and we can try to select that plane as soon as we clear the other. Select this point, select this plane, and we make those coincident. Now it's locked. So you can see it's right on the edge, it's locked in, it knows that we want to be 2 inches from that edge. But this circle is now floating into space, so how do we handle this? Well, here's a neat little trick. Features, and we can do our extruded base again. And first of all, let's do thin feature. We want a pipe, so let's say we'll make it 0.1 inches. So the wall thickness is 0.1 inches, and the inside diameter is 1 inch. So we can also reverse that and put the inside diameter on the outside by reversing the thin feature. Now you can see it's on the inside. Either way, it's up to you, however you decide to do it. Now, the one thing we can do is take this and we can go up to body. And what'll happen is, it'll take that part and it'll bring it directly through and make it one solid piece up into the body of this cup. The problem is our tube doesn't go through. Well, we can fix that problem too. The easiest way to do that would be to select this top surface, hit sketch, and we're selecting that one because it's flat, so it makes it easiest to use. And quickly, simply just select the inside circle and then convert entity. I don't think we've used that one before. And it makes a circle exactly the same size as that inner diameter. Then we go to feature and we extrude cut. We're not going to do through all because remember, if we do through all, what's going to happen? It's going to cut right through to the other side. We don't want that. So we just need to select a dimension that won't cut all we drew, and that's a blind cut, and we'll just call it 2 inches. You can see, well actually 2 inches might be a little too long, so we'll just go 1.5 to be safe. You can see it's only gonna go 1.5 in. It's gonna cut anything that is in the way. So remember, if you do through wall, it's gonna go out to infinity and cut anything it finds throughout that space. If you do blind, you can set how deep you make that cut. Let's say we wanted to put another pipe on the bottom. We could simply select that sketch, do our circle as usual, select, make sure we're on the origin or the center, and then smart dimension it. We'll make that one also 1 inch. And we'll use the same feature. We'll say we want extrude, thin, reverse it, 0.1, and we'll come out 1/2 inch. And now you can see that we have the pipe again, but we still have the same problem. So we can do that by selecting this plane. You can either do this one or you can select this one, but we're just doing the inside plane for now. Doesn't really matter in this case. Sketch. And then we're going to go and we're going to select this. We're going to convert the entity. And now you can see that it took this circle and moved it to the surface that we selected. And we go feature and extrude a cut. And in this case, because there's nothing in the way, we can just do through all. And now our part is completely done. Now remember, we can take a look at this part and by selecting our section view, we can even use section view to go in and select these if we wanted to put some radiuses on it, but we're not going to in this case. We got to finish up on this video. And we can also go to the selection view here and we can look at it in different formats with different shading. So we could do wireframe. This gives you, those of you who are familiar with engineering drawings, it gives you the inside lines as dotted lines and the outside is solid. Another thing we can do is we can go back to the eyeglasses and we can turn off our planes just to get a better view. But generally speaking, I leave it like this. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and we're going to be bringing you many more 5-minute tutorials for SolidWorks. Join us again, and don't forget to subscribe.